أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وبه يستعين في جميع الأمور الحمد لله الذي جعل كلمة الإمامة باقية في ذرية الحسين وصلى الله على محمد نبيه وآله الطاهرين ودعاته من المصطفين مؤمنين مؤمنات Those who recognize the Imam Tayyibul Asr, Allah's Wali, who brings safety and security to the world. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May you be among the people who recognize the Imams from Rasulullah's descendants in the line of Hussein. One Imam following another, each appointed by his predecessor, by Nas. Who recognize their heir and successor, Tayyib al-Asr, Waliyul Fath wa Nasr, in this way that when the Imam is in concealment, you obey and love his da'i. Mumineen, who when death comes to them, attain eternal life. Today, I, Mamluk Ali Muhammad, my Mawla Imam Zaman, servant and da'i, give light to Mumineen's discerning eyes and show them that our Mawla Imam Zaman, about whom Allah Ta'ala says in the Quran, وَكُلَّ شَيْءٍ أَحْسَيْنَاهُ فِي إِمَامٍ مُبِينٍ We have encompassed everything in the Imam. Our Mawla Imam Zaman is present today on the face of the earth. His presence is compulsory according to God's decree. In the previous majlis, I explained how people of enmity usurped the right of Rasulullah's wasi, his khalifa, his appointed successor, Amir al-Mumineen, Ali ibn Abi Talib, salawatullahi alayhi. How they seized the outward role of the khilafa, caliphate. Rasulullah had appointed Ali publicly among thousands of people in Ghadir Khum, and still, the majority turned away from him. This is the state of the world and the people of the world. It is nothing to wonder at than if this keeps recurring over centuries. Amir al-Mumineen was killed in Kufa. You heard the narration of his martyrdom recently in Shahr Ramadan. Ali appointed Hassan. Hassan is the true Imam. Hassan effected a truce with Muawiyah for reasons of wisdom. Inshallah, I will discuss that in detail another time. And Hassan Imam returned to Medina and let Muawiyah take over the outward role of the caliphate. Hassan Imam conducted the true da'wah in Medina until the time that Muawiyah had him poisoned and killed. Hassan appointed Hussein. The people of Kufa betrayed Hussein, Lain Yazid killed Hussein in Karbala. Before Hussein was killed, at the time that he bid the family farewell, he appointed Zainul Aabedin as the next Imam. This bayan is always narrated in our waaz sermons. The true Imam, Ali ibn al-Hussein, Zainul Aabedin, appointed his son, Muhammad al-Baqir, as his successor. Zainul Aabedin, Imam's other son, whose name is Zayd, Baqir Imam's brother. Those who follow Zayd are called Zaydis. Inshallah, I will do bayan in today's majlis about the historical events that caused the Zaydi faction to split off and the proof that show that they are on the path of falsehood. I do this bayan with Allah Ta'ala's aid and His Wali Imam Zaman's ta'id and guidance. Allah Ta'ala says about Nas appointment in the Quran Majid that Ibrahim Nabi and Yaqub Nabi instructed their sons. Inna Allah astafa lakum ad-deen fala tamutunna illa wa antum muslimun. Allah has chosen His religion for you. So do not die except after you have given over His trust. Meaning that you should appoint your successor and pass on the trust of the Imamate before you die. The true Imam and Da'i is one who is appointed by his true predecessor. The chain of true guides continues in this manner. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had said to Jabir bin Abdullah al-Ansari that you will live a very long life and you will meet the grandson of my grandson Hussein. His name is Muhammad. Convey to him my greetings, my salam, and say to him from me, Ya Baqir al-Ilmi, Ibkir al-Ilma Baqra. Meaning, O you who splits open the closed secrets of knowledge. Baqir means to split open, reveal the hidden knowledge. Sayyidina Idris writes in his kitab that this report that Rasulullah instructed Jabir to convey his special salam to Muhammad al-Baqir was an indication of nas, of appointment as Imam. Now in Baqir Imam's era, his brother, whose name was Zayd, he saw that the Shia were coming together in support of Baqir Imam. Zayd said to Baqir Imam, why do you not unsheathe your sword? You should rouse the people to fight, to do jihad. Baqir Imam answered, that time will come, it is not here yet. Zayd retorted that no, the one who among us who unsheathes his sword to claim the right of the Prophet's family is the one who is really the Imam, not the one who sits at home. He meant the one who fights for the outward form of the Caliphate. Baqir Imam answered that whoever among us unsheathes his sword before Mahdi will be like a baby bird that tries to fly when its wing feathers are not yet grown. He will fall and perish. Then Baqir Imam said to Zayd, fear God. Zayd, do not unsheathe your sword. Let it not happen that you are crucified tomorrow in the market of Kufa. Initially, a lot of Shia sided with Zayd, thinking that he was acting on behalf of Baqir Imam. Then they found out that this was not the case and many turned away from him, from Zayd. Some Shia even debated with Zayd and challenged him that, have you been appointed Imam? He said no. The Shia then said, Baqir Imam is appointed by Nas, by his father. He is the true Imam. The report is long. Zayd did take out his sword to fight and he was killed. What Baqir Imam had warned him of happened. Those who supported Zayd believed him to be the Imam. There are Zaydi followers today too. Their belief is that an Imam has three qualifications. One, he must be a descendant of the Prophet from Ahle Bayt Muhammad. Two, he should unsheathe his sword and fight and claim his right. And three, he should be learned. Our Hudaat, Dawat have refuted the claims of the Zaydis with great eloquence and logic. Zaydis claim that an Imam should have knowledge. But their Imams have taken their doctrine of Allah's oneness, Tawheed, from the Mu'tazili faction. Mu'tazili Sunni faction. Knowledge of God is the highest part and foundation of all knowledge. And they rely for it on the Sunni Mu'tazila. In terms of religious practice, law, fiqh, they follow the path of the Sunni Hanafi denomination. They take their fiqh from Abu Hanifa. They also do not disassociate from the first, second and third Sunni Khalifa who usurped the right of the Prophet's family. What knowledge do the Zaydi Imams possess then that they claim to be the true Imam? Another thing the Zaydis claim is that an Imam is one who unsheathes sword and fights. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not fight when he lived in Makkah in the first 13 years of Islam. So according to the Zaydis, was Rasulullah a true Rasul then? Amir al-Mu'mineen stayed home for 25 years. He did not unsheathe his sword. Hassan Imam made a treaty. Indeed, that is why Rasulullah had said, Al-Hassan wa al-Husayn, Imam haqqin qama'u qa'ada wa abuhuma khairun minhuma. Hassan and Hussein are true imams, whether they stand up or sit down, meaning whether they take out their sword or do not, and their father is greater than them. According to the Zaydis, then Hassan is not a true imam. Do they believe in Rasulullah's words or not? And when the Zaydis say that any one of the Prophet's family, meaning descendants of Hassan and Hussein, can be an imam, if he takes out his sword and is learned, if that is the case, then there could be two or three individuals in any age who fulfill these criteria. And in fact, that has happened in the Zaydi denomination. Their history itself speaks for it. That three individuals claimed to be the imam on this basis and fought among each other. Who should be believed then? If one is obeyed, another is disobeyed. If the imamate is claimed by individuals without a defining criterion, this kind of foggy situation is inevitable. It has also happened several times in the Zaydi faction that there have been times when there is no imam at all. Even now, they say for the past 25 years, they have no imam. This is their sorry situation. They denied the doctrine and the event of Nas, appointment by the predecessor of his successor imam. And they abandoned the true imam, which is why their religion became corrupted. Their shari'at became altered. Their doctrine became distorted. There were many Zaydi imams in Yemen, and they fought many battles against our da'is. They persecuted mu'mineen and killed many. Many were so afraid that they became Zaydis. There are many lengthy reports in the books of history. Mu'mineen, mu'minat, the true da'wat, haqni da'wat, flourishes today and will remain standing forever. The chain of appointment, nasno silsilo, continues. Even though enemies wield their sword of enmity, they are rushing towards perdition and death. They are already being destroyed. Allah has given a temporary reprieve, but He can seize them whenever He wishes. Mu'mineen, always recite this tasbih, litany, ehdina sirat al-mustaqim. Allah, guide us to the straight path. The straight path is this chain of nas, of divine appointment. The straight path is the station, the person of the true guide, the true imam in Da'i. Hold fast to his allegiance. Do not succumb to the pressure of the enemy. Do not succumb to the pressure of the enemy, factions, lies. Let not Satan, Shaitan steal away your entry into paradise. We give praise and thanks to Allah Ta'ala for placing us among the people of obedience. As Maulana Taher Fakhruddin eloquently wrote in his Risala, Nuti'u fi libasi taqwa. Imaman minhum ba'da imam wa da'iyannahum ba'da da'in yahfazu ladinihim al-nizab. Meaning, wearing the garments of taqwa, we obey imam after imam and da'i after da'i who safeguard the imam's da'wat. By the hurmat, sanctity of Muhammad, Ali Muhammad and their du'at, we pray that just as we took barakat and prayed in Ramadan, may Allah make each of our days the day of Eid in happiness, and each of our nights like Laylatul Qadr in auspiciousness. May Allah Ta'ala keep mu'mineen, mu'minat safe in this time of the pandemic, especially our brothers and sisters who are residing in India. Walhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulihi سيدنا محمد وآله الطاهرين وسلم تسليما متصلا إلى يوم الدين
يا صباح